Holy Jesus. What is that? What the fuck is that?
Figure out what Black Tusk was after. But the important thing is that we got it and they didn't. Well done.
Hey guys, how are we doing today? Welcome to another Division 2 build video. Episode 1 has dropped and skill builds got a huge buff. This adds a lot of build diversity to the game, which it badly needed. I took a few weeks off from the game, but now I'm back. I've actually been back for a few weeks. I have been grinding, and today I finally got the BTSU gloves. These gloves are for status effect skill builds. Status effects for the Division 2 are burn or on fire, bleed, poison, blindness, disorient, disrupt, and shock and paralysis. This build I'm going to show you today is for the status effect blindness. Now the BTSU data gloves give you some crazy buffs, but in order to get them, you first need to apply a status effect to the enemies. So in this case, I'm using the Blinder Firefly. So let's go over the talents real quick on these gloves and why these are so OP. First is Elemental Gadgetry. Skills that apply status effects gain 50% status effect duration and 50% skill haste. So when I throw my Blinder Firefly, the status effects last 50% longer, and I will get it back 50% quicker. Next is Energy Infusion. Whenever you apply a status effect, your gloves become infused with that effect for 60 seconds. So, as you saw in my gameplay, when your gloves turn from blue to red, that will last a minute. So why that is happening for that next minute while infused, you gain 10% skill damage, 10% skill healing and repair, and 10% skill duration. You can see that I have 8. So that's going to give me 80% more damage to my Seeker Mines. I'm not using any healing or repair skills. And duration, that would be great for like a turret or a drone. Applying the same status effect while infused does not refresh the infusion. So during that 60 seconds, if I throw my Firefly again, it will not refresh it. I have to wait until that 60 seconds is up. And the last one is charged proxies. Whenever you throw a skill 1.25 seconds after landing, it creates an explosion, applying the infused status effect to all enemies within 6 meters. So when I throw my seeker mine 1.5 seconds after landing, it's going to cause that status effect, blinding, to all the enemies within 6 meters. Enemies affected by the infused status effect take 50% more damage from your skills. So that's going to give me another more 50% damage on my seeker mines. And then you can see for my mods, I have a nice one there with skill power and explosive damage. And then that other mod, that is the highest skill power mod I have, the XP. Don't really care for that. A little bit more burn duration. So that is the gloves. Let's move on to the rest of the build. Next is my China Light Industries mask. I choose this one for the 10% explosive damage for my seeker mines. This also has great attributes of 391 skill power, 10% damage deletes, and the best talent for this build, in my opinion, 20% skill haste. This mask is darn near perfect. Next is my Alps Summit chest piece. I use the two-piece Alps Summit for 20% skill haste and 5% skill power. This one has a great 440 skill power. That vital, I would like to roll that off again for skill haste. Next is my Providence defense holster. I am looking for a better holster right now. This one I choose because the two-piece, you only need one to get that 10% skill power. But this one has health. It has also a 310 skill power as well. Next is my second piece, Providence. This is my knee pads. I choose this one because it has a good skill power roll and, of course, that 20% skill haste. And the last part of my build is the Alps backpack. This is the second piece for that 5% skill power and 20% skill haste. For my skill mods, I'm always looking for the highest skill power. I'm also looking for bleed damage or burn damage or explosive damage. But mainly, I'm just looking for the most skill power that I can get. So now let's go over my skills. Now to activate your gloves, you're going to want to use the Blinder Firefly first. This will give you that 60% window where your seeker mines do crazy damage. So the Blinder Firefly is pretty straightforward. You throw it, it's going to cause a blinding effect to all the enemies. The animation and sound effects, I think, is really cool. My mods on here are for skill haste and skill power. Targeting mod, I haven't got one yet, so I'm still on the hunt for one. Now, Seeker Mine, I could use two different ones. I could use the explosive or the cluster. I choose the cluster because it's going to hunt out numerous enemies. It's going to split off into 4 separate mines. Each mine has a blast radius of 4 meters. You can cover up to 16 meters. That's a wide area. When all your buffs are active, each one is going to do some crazy damage, as you saw in my gameplay in the beginning. Alright guys, that will do it for this video. I wanted to make this because when I got the gloves, I was a little confused on how to put everything together. So hopefully this cleared up and answered some questions for you. If you do have any other questions, let me know in the comments below and I'll answer those as soon as I can. If you liked what you saw, hit that like button. If it's your first time here, please think about subscribing. I'd really appreciate it. We'll see you in the next video.